dentist's office, I go to pick up my magazine, I flip, and there's Christopher, front and center, horse and hound.
Look at my horse, yours has nothing on mine.
This is Horse News USA, now here is Christopher.
These are my horses, there aren't many like it, but these two are mine.
Someone paid for me? That's fantastic. I'm gonna pay for the 18-wheeler behind me.
Well, you are tape. It's nice when someone wants to give.
I'm being a little generous with this giant box of quarters I have.
Experiment. I've been trying to turn that cat to a dog all week.
Don't you worry, meow. We haven't got a plan for you. You're going home with me.
Hey, mister, please, can you get these cuffs off me?
Is that a bird? Is that a plane?
No, that's the cat saver.
You did what? You stole a cat? Quick, send your brother to go cover up the evidence.
Scott! That's the best eggnog I've ever had.
Alright, alright. Just when you get too used to the old stuff, then we come in with something really nice and new.
Hey, bartender, let me get another, what is it, a Colima?
go to, but I couldn't get my passport because we didn't have the right birth certificate. So I stayed home, they went, but I got to be home alone without no family. And they had fun at home.
Okay, nope. So your family gets to go on this awesome trip, but actually the gift was given to you because you were family free.
Yes.
Vacation. I got a gallon of ice cream, get a large pie.
Pluto, and you were once thought as a planet, and you weren't, now you are.
Okay. I was once thought of as a planet, but I'm not a planet, but now I am.
Yeah.
And well, let's watch.
It's not Pluto the dog, I'm Pluto the planet. I used to know.
Want a cold beer? But this is Germany!
After crawling through the desert, finally, someplace where I can... What is this? Room temperature?
After a while, it's not even gonna matter whether the beer is warm or cold. Just as long as you have somebody to share.
Thank you.
And so that's what I did. I got in my car, and my feelings were really hurt that this awesome car has this big dent in the hood. And when you're driving that car, it seems like everybody starts to stare at you, right? It's like, wow, nice car, but ooh. And so you start to feel embarrassed. So off I go, I call the insurance adjuster, and I'm like, I've had insurance ever since I can remember. I've never had an accident. I've never had a ticket. And now I need this fixed. So the insurance adjuster says, oh, you know what, Mr. Bledsoe, we're going to take care of you because you have this perfect driving record and the damage is under a certain amount. So this isn't going to count against you on your insurance. And I'm like, yes.
I was on the phone.
Yes.
Hello.
Can I help you?
Yeah, I have a question. Not to be stick in the mud, but when you drive a car like mine, you don't really want to be stuck with a compact car. And I haven't even got so much as a speeding ticket. Could you help me out a little bit?
Well, let me put you on hold for a moment. My assistant, they'll help you out.
Turns out, nothing. So I called the body shop. I'm like, listen, what can you do for me?
I'm sorry, but you're not supposed to call my car, but that's it. Nothing's allowed for you to see me.
I didn't know what to do. I was stuck. So I called him up again.
Yes? Can I help you?
Come on. What can you do for me?
Well, what did the body shop person say?
They said I'm stuck with it.
You're not stuck with it. I can take care of this for you. I know somebody, and they'll have no problem getting what you want. Just let me get a hold of them, and I'll get right back to you.
Thank you. Thank you so much.